Welcome to the Piping Engineering YouTube channel. In today's video, we will learn simple formulas to easily calculate the center-to-center elbow length, determine elbow degree angles, and find the true length of pipes in a double-rolled pipeline. First of all, thank you to all our members and subscribers for your amazing support. If you'd like to support our educational mission, subscribe or check out our membership packages linked in the description below. All right. Let's dive into today's lesson. To determine the length of a pipe section between two elbows in a pipeline, we will follow these steps. Calculate the overall length and the center-to-center distance between the two elbows. Determine the angle, length of the elbows, and their takeoff dimensions. Finally, subtract the elbow lengths and welding gaps from the overall length. The formula can be expressed as pipe length equals overall length, 2 times elbow length, 2x caps for welding. We will perform all these calculations step by step on this 8-inch pipeline section. Let's denote the overall length or the center-to-center distance between the elbows as L. In our previous videos, we explained that the double rolling part of the pipeline is easier to understand when visualized within a right-angled parallelogram. As you can see, the 8-inch pipeline extends southwards. At the top right corner of the parallelogram, the pipeline first descends by 441 mm, then continues southwards for 978 mm before turning eastwards for 444 mm. Finally, at the bottom left corner of the parallelogram, the pipeline again continues southwards. During the double rolling of a pipeline, two right angle triangles are formed using dashed lines. We will use these triangles to calculate the overall length, elbow length, and true pipe length. Let's first label the hypotenuse of the horizontal dashed line right angle triangle with the letter H and then determine its length. To find this hypotenuse, we will use the Pythagorean theorem. According to the Pythagorean theorem, the square of the hypotenuse H will be equal to the sum of the squares of 978 and 444. Using a calculator and find that the square of 978 will equal 956484, and the square of 444 will equal 197136. So, we continue to calculate that h squared will equal 956484 plus 197136. Using the calculator again, 956484 plus 197136 will equal 1153620. So, we find that h squared will equals 1153620. Again, using a calculator, h will equal the square root of 1153620, it will equal approximately 1074. So, after performing the calculations, we found that the length of the hypotenuse of the horizontal dashed line right-angle triangle is 1074 mm. The hypotenuse of the horizontal right triangle also serves as the perpendicular side of the vertical right triangle. Now, let's label the hypotenuse of the vertical dashed line right-angle triangle with the letter L and calculate its length. To find this hypotenuse, we will use the Pythagorean theorem again. According to the Pythagorean theorem, the square of the hypotenuse L will be equal to the sum of the squares of 441 and 1074. Using a calculator, we calculate that the square of 441 will equal 194481, and the square of 1074 will equal 1153476. So, we continue to calculate that L squared will equal 194,481 plus 1153476. Using the calculator again, 194481 plus 1153476 will equal 1347957. So, we find that L squared equals 1347957. Again, using a calculator, L will equal the square root of 1347957, which is approximately 1161. The hypotenuse of the vertical right triangle also serves as the overall length, or the center-to-center distance between the two elbows. So, after our calculation, we found that the overall length or the center-to-center distance between the two elbows is 1161 mm. Now calculate the elbow degree for these dimensions on this pipeline. To find the elbow degree, we will use the trigonometric function. So, if we denote this angle as A, then A degrees will be equal to the arctangent of 441 divided by 1074. Using a scientific calculator, the arctangent of 441 divided by 1074 will equal approximately 22 degrees. So, we calculated and found that the cutting angle of these elbows is 22 degrees on the 8-inch pipeline. Now we should find the length of the 8-inch 22-degree elbows. We will use this formula to find the length of the elbow which we have prepared and shared in many videos previously. I will also include the links to those videos in the description below. The elbow length will equal the tangent of elbow angle divided by 2 times 38.1 times the nominal pipe size NPS of the elbow. Now we will substitute our elbow angle and nominal pipe size information into this formula. So, our elbow length will equal the tangent of 22 divided by 2 multiplied 38.1 multiplied by 8. Using a scientific calculator, the tangent of 22 divided by 2 multiplied 38.1 multiplied by 8 will equal approximately 59 millimeters. So, we calculated and found that the length of the 8-inch 22-degree elbow is 59 millimeters in this pipeline. Also, from our other videos, we learned that during fit-up a small gap is required for welding. It should be approximately 3 to 4 millimeters. Now I will show you a small fragment in practice demonstrating how to set the fit-up gap for welding. Please watch it so you can get an idea of the gap in the fit-up. This gap is necessary for a good root weld. Now let's find out true length of the pipe length. Now, we will substitute our overall length, elbow lengths, and welding gap information into above formula. Pipe length equal the overall length 1161 minus 2 times the elbow length 59 and minus 2 times 3 for the caps for welding. Using a calculator, 1161 minus 2 multiplied by 59 minus 2 multiplied by 3 will equals 1037. So, we calculated and found that the red-colored pipe length between the two elbows is 1037 millimeters. By using this method, you can easily calculate the pipe lengths and elbow angles of pipe sections for your desired pipelines. This educational video ends here. Feel free to share your thoughts about the video in the comments section. By joining our channel, you can support us and enjoy exclusive features. If you enjoyed the video, please like and subscribe to our channel. We would like to thank everyone who commented on or liked our work to show their appreciation. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.